Now, you also made a comment a couple of minutes ago about mutilating surgery, okay? And I want to point out...
And yours is more mutilating than mine, by the way. I want to just point that out.
Well, I was about to... listen, man, I was about to segue to you to have you explain that I'm assuming either with the robot or laparoscopically the fine surgery that you can do. I think you ought to share with our listening and watching audience that not only should the ovaries be removed, but why don't we segue also into the fallopian tube removal, Mike?
Fascinating question. First of all, the current scientific theories for the the genesis of ovarian cancer, especially the BRCA time, the BRCA kind of ovarian cancers, is that they actually originate in the fallopian tubes, the end of the fallopian tubes, the fimbria, and that the cancer cells sprinkle down onto the ovaries or spread from there. And it's well proven. I mean, it's almost to the point of being fact now. And in Canada, there are big proponents for having risk reduction fimbriectomies and not even removing the ovaries. Wow. Now, this gets into a very complicated discussion because I mentioned earlier, if you remove the ovaries, you cut the breast cancer risk in half, whether you have a BRCA mutation or not. I mean, that's been known for many, many years. Removing the ovaries and that hormone source really cuts the breast risk and significantly. So Angelina could have chosen to have her ovaries removed and cut her breast risk in half. The mastectomy cut it by 90-95%. Mm-hmm. So I think what we can remove either the fimbria or the ovaries with small incisions, outpatient surgery, recovered in a few days. In the bigger scheme of things, it's a really minor surgery compared to the mastectomies. And so I think there's not much point in discussing the gynecologic surgery. It's almost a no-brainer. Once you've completed childbearing, it's a minor surgery. The biggest issue is not so much the surgery, it's the hormones. A lot of these young women with BRCA mutations don't want to have their ovaries out because they're afraid of hot flashes, their sex drive, and they can't take hormones. And here's my simple take on that. Your ovaries are like little pharmacies pumping out hormones. If you're 35 years old and your doctor takes out the ovaries, the studies have clearly shown, Rebeck studies have shown, BRCA patients can safely take hormone replacement therapy without a significant increased risk of getting breast cancer. And that's because you can replace the hormones at a lower level than they were making before. Yep. The problem is most doctors don't want to write that prescription for estrogen because if that woman gets breast cancer, they're going to probably sue the doctor because it caused their cancer. But the reality is, if you take the ovaries out, you can take hormones afterwards, albeit at a lower level, not be at increased risk for breast cancer, have quality of life, and not worry about that deadly cancer, ovarian cancer, that you can't screen for.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.